Prosecutors now say the two men from Yemen are suspects in a conspiracy to commit a terrorist act. Even though these men were not on the U.S. no-fly list, a White House spokesman is saying today that federal authorities are conducting a vigorous investigation into whether this was a test run for terrorism.
The men are held in custody on suspicion of a conspiracy to a terrorist criminal act. In a few days, it will be made public if they will be charged.
Officials from the Dutch Office of Public Prosecution say they arrested Ahmed Mohammed Nasser El Soufi and Hazem Al Marizi after they flew into Amsterdam from Chicago Monday morning. They were detained when United Flight 908 landed, based on information from U.S. authorities. Inside El Soufi's checked luggage that traveled to Washington, a cell phone taped to a Pepto-Bismol bottle, watches taped to a shampoo bottle, other cell phones taped together, box cutters and knives. Some U.S. officials say an investigation is underway into whether this was a dry run for a possible terrorist attack, but another government official says that's unlikely. Al Soufi used to live in the Detroit area, spending time in Dearborn and Monroe. He recently moved to Alabama. When he boarded a plane there on Sunday, airport screeners stopped him for an additional search because of his bulky clothing. Screeners found $7,000 in cash on Al Soufi, but it's not illegal to carry that amount of money. When Al Soufi arrived in Chicago, he caught the attention of security officials there because his luggage got onto a plane bound for Dulles Airport in Washington, but he got on a different flight for Amsterdam. Al Marizi also used to live in the Detroit area. He flew into Chicago from Memphis, and his flight changed too. Both were ultimately trying to get to the capital of Yemen, and both ended up on the United flight to the Netherlands. Friends of Al Soufi say it's not uncommon for people to travel with items taped together that are designated for friends and relatives at home.
Some people, they like to do it. You know why? Maybe somebody give it to him and he want to give it to somebody without nobody sensing a phone or something like that and give him, hey, I tape it, I put your name on it. I don't want him to give you a different kind of phone or something.
Once again, Homeland Security officials are working right now to find out if this is all just a misunderstanding, but there has been a recent heightened alert because of some information about possible Mideast hijackings, especially in Dubai, and these men apparently fit that alert pattern. Officials in Yemen do say there is a major cell phone shortage there, so it's not unusual for travelers to bring extras home with them. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Heather Cataldo, Channel 7 Action News. Vic, back to you.
Heather, I'm just curious. You said the men have been detained, but have they actually been charged with a crime?
Well, yesterday we had information that they had been charged. Now Dutch officials are saying they're just detained and they're being questioned at the airport. Under the law there, they can be held for up to 6 days before they're charged. Vic?